start the show. Well, I'll start the show. It's drive time again, doing 29C. For a 19th day of April 2013, it's 1:17 p.m. in the p.m. Eastern Standard. It's a Friday. Don't have any plans. Gonna take it easy tonight. Gonna take it easy. And still, you know, I was, you know, sucked into the TV there at lunch break. Learned nothing new. No new developments. I gotta get past it for the one big reason. I have a shit ton of work I have to do at work today to get my brain right, to get past the blocks I'm having. So I gotta focus in on it. I gotta do that. And I guess, you know, and I try to think like, well, let me rewind back to the beginning of this day. Circa 9:05 a.m., I figured I'd walk into the workplace where I work, and then and all the co-workers would be chatting it up about it, you know? Not the case. No one, very minimal chatter at the office. Minimal chatter. So, you know, I gotta get past this, and if I don't find out the news, you know, as soon as it happens, I'll check, you know, again, you know, let's listen in.
50 degrees, rain or beat.
We'll do the weather. Weather is what it is. I hope it doesn't rain, so I did want to run outside tonight. I'm getting back up behind on that badly, too. Gotta get back in the gear with that. Gotta get back in the flow with that. Yeah, I don't know. Chechnya is the place where these guys are from. Chechnya. I guess there's Muslims over there, and I don't know. They did a brief history lesson. You know, it just seems like, I immediately had this conspiracy theory thought in my brain that, okay, maybe these guys, this was a scheme drummed up. Maybe it's a false flag in that this Chechnya area is still fighting with Russia mainland, Moscow. You know, I say Moscow, I mean like the government, Russia proper, ex-Soviet Union struggle, power hold, Putin et al, that faction. What if this is a joint false flag op between Putin and Obama, and this was to drum up support for a U.S., presence, a greater presence, like a warlike presence, to batten down what maybe secretly the U.S. and the Russian governments have viewed as a growing number of extremist Muslim threat. So this was a false flag to drum up the public support for that. Listen, I came up with that in 2 seconds. And I didn't hear that anywhere, but I would bet on it that right there is the nonsense that someone like Alex Jones is going to be spouting. And that's not to say that it isn't even there's isn't a flicker of chance that something like that is true. But all you're doing when you engage in that type of thinking is, you know, it's conspiracy theories are themselves, actually, the conspiracy theorist, the guy who gets into a broad range of them, you know, doesn't just dabble and find them. I find them interesting. I like to read about them, but I do not go overboard with it at all. Some things are more interesting than others. You know, people try to link the Connecticut one with the little kindergartners to a false flag operation to take our guns away. Well, the gun fucking bill didn't pass. So fuck. Like, how do you know what? It, so they killed these kids to for some, and then it didn't pass. Like, what the fuck? So some of these guys have just got to get their head checked because it just doesn't add up. But sometimes I see a little thing. But I think that my point being here is that I think the people get into conspiracy theory. It's a religion. It's coming up with answers to questions that no one knows. which is the basis for religion. And that's what the conspiracy theory people are doing. It's a wacky religion. It's like a cult thing, you know? And you get to have friends, because you can say, oh, I'm part of this group that thinks this way. And you have little buddies. That's all people are trying to do, you know? I find the hardest part is just go through life without any kind of stability there, and just to let the questions linger. You know? Let's check it out in the news.
Monday, overnight, they were throwing explosives of one kind or another at police officers, and now apparently more have been discovered in this house.
It seems that way, and it adds to, it's not an answer, it adds, you know, to a question we've been struggling with, which is, if they did conduct this attack, why? And if there was a why not a claim of responsibility to frame that why? Because terrorism is all about inciting fear and making people know what they're supposed to be afraid of. And if there wasn't a claim of responsibility that went to a why, and there's leftover explosives, and they certainly didn't flee the area, did they have something else planned? And what was to be next?
Getting pieces of information into our newsroom all morning and all afternoon, starting to piece together a picture of these suspects. The latest we've heard from CBS producer, that is Pat Nelson.
Listen a little longer.
The suspect is still out there, became a U.S. citizen on September 11th of last year. Also, that the suspect's mother was arrested in 2012 for stealing $1,600 worth of clothing. That's the suspect's mother. We're not sure what exactly is going to be relevant as this investigation continues.
So the 9/11, I heard that he was born on 9/11. No, I'm sorry. He was became a citizen on 9/11. I heard that. And I heard the lady on the news, MSNBC, when I was home for lunch, said, she said, that's impossible that would be a coincidence. I'm like, impossible? Like, there's a decent chance that was a coincidence. I know it didn't happen that long ago, so he had to have been already kind of going down this path when he. So, you know, maybe it wasn't a coincidence, but it could have been. She was pretty sure that was not a coincidence. That just, you know, just a date. Might have lined up that way. Listen back in.
He had personal martial arts skills, but they've beyond that shown some operational sophistication that has police a little bit concerned. Two guys that came to the country years ago, they weren't troublemakers as far as we know. They didn't appear on police radar in any significant way, so they were totally off the grid. And somehow they're able to concoct this scheme, buy the materials, put together the devices, carry out the bombings, and escape the bombing scene undetected. That's a level of professionalism, if you will, in terror attacks that have police knowing they're dealing with serious customers here. Now, what changed was last night when the pictures came public. These guys came out from wherever they were hiding and took some really kind of silly chances in comparison to what they had done prior to that. I mean, robbing a 7-Eleven store is not, particularly sophisticated. Shooting the officer certainly attracts attention. That's a terrible thing that happened there with the MIT officer. But they started to make mistakes. What they're hoping now is, as they press harder on Jokar Tsarnaev, they're hoping he makes a change. And they're obviously hoping that it doesn't blend in with further bad consequences. They're concerned, Scott.
All right. Well, I can't do this all day. It does seem insane that this bad traffic saw is going a little longer here. It does seem fucking insane that they haven't gotten it. This is like out of a movie. Like he ran over his brother. Like, it felt like he ran his own brother over to get away and went through the cops. And now he's gone. How did they lose it? All right, signing off.